Hey, Coach, thanks for joining us. We've got a few questions from Kelly Kroll.
Well, Coach, I'm sure you'd never point to fatigue as an excuse, but what did you see in the second half from your guys that changed from the first half?
Really, it really was neither half. The first half, we weren't competitive tonight. We got off to a good start. I think some of the shots went down, but we didn't have the same competitive drive. I thought we had a couple good plays and a couple good moments in the first quarter, and you could feel it. I thought we should have been up 20 at the half. For them to be down 11 was our inability to really push, and that was just kind of a lack of competition that we needed in a game like this. You don't want a team like this to stick around, and this is the reason why.
There was a big emphasis points in the paint, keeping them out of the paint tonight. When you look at that area, how do you assess the job that you guys did?
Fair at best. I thought they do a really good job probing and on their penetration, finding late looks. JaVale really hurt us crashing, making some drop offs, and their bigs in general were just effective around the basket. But I thought we could have done a much better job of shrinking the floor, of applying a little bit more pressure on their cuts. They were hitting their bigs at the elbow, and they were just moving around, and we just didn't have the type of finish that we needed defensively.
And if you don't mind me asking just really quick, any update on Kevin Herter? We saw him leave the floor at one point.
I have no idea.
Thank you.
Sarah.
Lloyd, how much did turnovers hurt you guys tonight, and what were kind of the biggest reasons for the
it's the lack of competition. In the same game you get a 5 second back down and a half court violation. We didn't have any kind of we didn't really have any mojo. Those are two plays where we're just playing slow and doing things that are uncharacteristic. And I just thought, I don't know if that was fatigue. We were just out of sorts. And I just thought it was a quiet group. I thought for the first time, practice or non-practice, game or off the court, I thought that was the first time that we were a little disconnected or discombobulated. So it was just a weird day, weird feeling for guys out there. We never got the rhythm. Obviously, the shots weren't falling. The turnovers were high. And then they found life.
What did you see out of Clint Capela tonight?
Carry over. He's getting better every game. You're seeing his activity. 8 offensive rebounds is just pure effort. And, that's a bright spot for him and his activity and him finding some rhythm in some areas that he can be effective. Getting to the free throw line, he didn't capitalize, but being able to get to the free throw line was his activity, a product of his activity. And we need that. We need him to be every bit of a guy that's effective around the basket on both ends of the floor, and we're seeing more and more of that from him.
Terrell Thomas.
Coach, this is the first time with your new group and the new roster that you guys had a back-to-back. How much do you feel like that back-to-back maybe played in part in the slow start in the second half? And what went into your decision to leave the reserves out in the second half for such a long time?
To leave them out?
Yeah, it seems like they got slightly more minutes once Cleveland went on a run. We saw Trae Young was on the bench during that time. Once they got once the lead was down to about 4 points, we saw Trae get off the bench. Was there any reason why during that stretch the reserves were out on the floor?
It's the same rotation we've used in every game. They actually reduced it. I actually brought the starters back in the fourth quarter a little bit earlier. We had a somewhat of a lead. I think it was 11 when it took most of the starters out, and we didn't finish the third quarter well, and it ends up being a 4-point game. And it's really a one possession, two possession game early in the fourth. And I just thought if we could slowly, I think a sub Bogey in first and ended up bringing Kevin pretty much after that. It was hard to think that if we just stayed the course when that end of the third quarter run really just evaporated for us. They took the lead and they got into a point where they were climbing into our guys, and I wanted to get our starters back and see if we had one final push, and it just stayed a one possession game until they took the lead, and we didn't have any fight. But you know, we've kind of kept a consistent rotation with when our second unit guys are coming in and when our starters are going out. And tonight it probably changed. Kevin ended up playing a lot more minutes. He was playing well before he rolled his ankle. And so I kept him out there with the starters just because I thought he was the guy that was playing well.
Thank you, Coach.
Greg Hurd.
Hey, Coach, through the first four games, Trey's averaged about 15 free throws a game. The last two games, he has a combined eight. But with this game in particular, do you think there was anything with the Cavs' defensive effort, especially Dante Exum, that kind of kept him off the line?
You know, he normally knows how to create them. He didn't get many of those opportunities. Where guys, obviously, if you watch film, you start to learn how to defend a guy. And, you know, hopefully if you're disciplined and you're doing your defensive game plan, you can avoid being in those situations where you're fouling. And I thought they did a good job. JB had his guys ready to defend without fouling. And he's the main guy. He's been leading the league thus far. And they did a good job of keeping him off the free throw line.
Jacob Roth of CBS 46.
Hey, Lloyd, this is kind of a bigger picture question, but, you know, such a great win last night, kind of a letdown game tonight. How hard is it not to read too much into one game this early in the season with, you know, small sample size numbers all over the place? Is that just something that comes with experience, or how do you manage that?
Which game are you reading into, the Brooklyn one or tonight?
I guess, you know, both. You know, I guess you can't get too high or too low. How do you avoid trying to take too much from just one up or down, one way or the other?
I don't. Every game you learn from, you try and correct your mistakes. I think I said it yesterday. You know, you don't celebrate much in this league, and we weren't going to celebrate Brooklyn knowing we had a two-hour fight and got home at 3 and we had a game to play. We're not going to pout about losing to Cleveland. We're going to take a day off and we come back ready to go, and we got a game on Monday. And that's just how the flow is. I wasn't celebrating Brooklyn last night, and I won't be too angry about Cleveland tonight. It's a long season. We got to continually get better. You learn some things in a game like this. You learn some things in a game like last night, but you don't hang your hat. You got to keep moving forward. We got a lot of work to do, and we've said that from start to finish, and we'll continue to say that.
Thank you.
Two more, Kelly Kroll.
Coach, when you say that, to piggyback on that, what do you want your guys to learn from tonight specifically?
Stay together. We mentality, stay together. You know, we need everybody to bring it, and we need everybody to support each other. It's really that, you know, you're in a back-to-back. You kind of assume some guys may be tired. It's no excuse, but it's just a reality, and you're hoping other guys. I thought BG came in again and gave us a hell of a spark in that second quarter, and you're going to need that in games like this. But that's really the testament of a team. We have to stay together. We have to be able to incorporate different guys at different times, and when you're struggling to score or you're struggling to rebound or you're struggling to do certain things, you need someone to come in and give you a spark, and BG did that tonight in the second quarter. We just didn't have enough of it from a lot of guys in the second half.
Final question from Terrell Thomas.
Coach, you mentioned a moment ago that you felt like tonight the guys just didn't have the mojo they've had earlier this season. Communication wasn't there. A quick start again, as you mentioned, Monday the Knicks will be in town. What was your message for your team this evening, and what will you be looking for? What will you be looking for out of your team on Monday when the Knicks are here?
We got a day off tomorrow and get some rest. It's been a long week. Just got back into town late this morning, early this morning, however you say it. You know, and when we meet on Monday, we'll get prepared for New York. You know, we'll put this one to bed. That's all we talked about. We didn't really say anything about New York. I haven't seen New York. We'll put this one to bed and watch the film and be prepared for our game plan against New York and what we can do coming off a day off.
Thank you.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you.
Hey, Trey, thanks for joining us. We've got a question or two from Kelly Kroll at Fox Sports Southeast.
Hey, Trey. Coach just a minute ago said he just felt like you guys tonight didn't really have the mojo, the energy. What do you attest that to?
I don't know. I mean, for us, we just got to come out, just come out better and then just come out and just try to get a win. We should have played a little bit better and just didn't get a win.
Well, and really, you guys got off to a decent start when you think about it. But what do you feel like changed down the stretch? Did they make adjustments, or did you just not feel like, you know, shots were falling?
I think they just got comfortable. I think they got comfortable late in that third quarter, and then heading into the fourth, they just got comfortable. And then when it's a close game, it's anybody's game. There's no home court advantage here right now, and we're just out here playing basketball with not very many fans, and so you can't use that crowd, that home court advantage to your advantage. And for us, we just let them get into a rhythm. And I mean, they got into a rhythm and then it was close. And like I said, it's up in the air from there.
Sarah.
Trey, how much did turnovers kind of hurt you guys tonight, particularly some of those late in the game? And what was kind of some of the biggest reasons for those, you think?
Yeah, I think some of those turnovers for sure cost us the game. Got to take care of the ball more. A couple of those late in the clock. Got a 15-second call. I don't know how many of those I've gotten since I've been in the league. But it happened tonight. And just one of those things when they're in a rhythm and you're getting back into the game. Gotta lock in a little bit more.
One bright spot was kind of Clint's performance. Has it been good to see him kind of find his footing and have a strong two games?
For sure. Clint's been playing really well. Something we're gonna need from him all year. I know he's still getting back from the injury, and then we got to get some other guys back from injury, I'm excited to see what Clint's been doing, and he's been playing really well.
Terrell Thomas.
Trey, can you talk to us about your chemistry on the court with John Collins and Clint? We've seen a lot over the past few years with you and John Collins, but a few games in, but you guys seem like your chemistry has grown and you've developed even more on the court. Can you talk to us about that?
Yeah, I mean, our chemistry's always been strong. Our first games together were in summer league my rookie year. So we've been building a relationship on and off the court ever since then. So mine and John's relationship is really tight. You can tell on the court. And then me and Clint, we're really really tight off the court. And just trying to continue to build that connection. On the court, there's a couple lobs tonight. Just trying to get him. He had a couple of mismatches down low, and some of them were too high of passes, and just a little bit of miscommunication, and just things I can touch up and we can work on together once that chemistry gets stronger too.
Thank you.
Jamila Johnson.
Hey, Trey. I know it wasn't the outcome you guys wanted for the game, but what is it about DeAndre Hunter's game that you liked tonight? He had a solid game, and, you know, early on he was posting up Colin Sexton and you found him. What has it been about his growth that you'd like to see?
I mean, for me, it was all about confidence with Dre, and Dre's had a lot of confidence with him and Cam mainly. And for me, that was the main jump that I wanted to see from them two. And you see it with both of them, and particularly Dre. His scoring is going good for us. He had a lot of these same looks last year, but just didn't really use his body the way he is now. And when knocking down shots the way he is now, and you can tell he's putting in a lot of work, and it's paying off.
Got, I think, two more. Back to Terrell Thomas.
Trey, with this being the first game, or excuse me, with this being the first time your team has had a back-to-back, what do you feel like you've learned about this team during this stretch, and where do you feel like you can improve yourself and as a team going forward in the next back-to-back series?
I think for us, we learn. We got to be we play really well on our stretch of three games before on the road to start the season. Played really well, and just now we got to protect home, and that's something that we just got to do. And I mean, I'll continue to get better, like I always have. And as the season goes on, it'll continue to get better.
Thank you, Trey. Thanks for joining us. We will get started as soon as the hand goes up in Zoom. And there it is from Sarah Spencer.
Hey, Kevin. So offensively, you guys looked pretty good in that first quarter. But what kind of changed in the fourth that kind of led to you guys not being able to score down the stretch there?
Yeah, you know, we just went cold. You know, we weren't getting good shots. You know, I don't think we're making them work enough. But give credit to them. Their ball screen defense was really good. You know, JaVale is tough when he's down the court. It's a little bit tougher for guards to get to the rim, and he's good at taking away the lob. So you give credit where credit's due. We got to do a better job of getting downhill, getting easier, better shots. And we didn't do that in the second half.
Kevin Chenard.
How are you feeling after whatever it was that precipitated you to leave in the fourth?
I'm feeling all right. Just kind of tweaked my ankle a little bit. Kind of waiting to see how I feel tomorrow. You know, my speculation, it's, you know, it doesn't feel that bad. I don't think it'll be a long-term thing. But I don't know yet. Just kind of tweaked it. And we'll figure more out tomorrow. Right now, it's not, you know, not the worst thing.
Any additional questions for Kevin? There are currently no hands up in the queue. So, Kevin, I think we're going to get you out of here, man. Thank you for joining us.
Cool. Thanks, Thank Kevin.
Hey, Clint, thanks for joining us. We've got questions from Sarah Spencer. Let's do
it. Hey, Clint, what were the biggest things that gave you guys trouble toward the end of the third quarter and in that fourth quarter?
Can you repeat, please?
Oh, what were the no, that's okay. Sorry, the mask messes everything up. What were the biggest things that gave you guys trouble toward the end of the third quarter and then in the fourth quarter as well?
Yeah, I think we were missing a little bit of energy during the third quarter. I mean, we were up 10, 12, so they came back. And whenever the team comes back like that, it's kind of it makes – it's harder. Like, you make yourself in a situation that it's really hard to recreate that advantage that you had. So we were missing a little bit of that tonight.
Does playing on the second night of a back-to-back make it even harder, talking about that energy?
I mean, yeah, obviously. Maybe it's a little bit of that. Maybe it could be something else sometimes. Bad night shooting. I mean, yeah, it's not only that, because we were really good in this game. We were up 10, 12, 13. So we had the control of this game. We just lost control of it.
Jamila.
Hey, Clint. With your experience and with how vocal you are with the team, what is your message to the young guys about, you know, having this type of game?
That it's a long season. It's going to be some up and downs. It's going to be games like that. But the best thing and the only thing that you can do is learn from it and get on the next one. We know what we did wrong tonight. We know what we can learn from it tonight. And especially for next game, we still have games that are really important for us. The whole season is going to be important for us. So the best thing that we can do is move forward, learn from it and move forward.
Terrell Thomas.
Clint, I was watching what a lot of Atlanta Hawks fans were saying on social media during the game, and you've been the answer to a lot of their prayers this season. Hawks fans have been craving for a big in the middle. As it was mentioned before, second game of a back-to-back. How do you feel? How do you feel as you're getting adjusted to this new Hawks system?
I feel better. I'm really happy to feel the love from the Hawks fan. But yeah, I gotta say that I'm still getting adjusted. So I don't feel that I'm there yet, but I definitely feel better in the system and start feeling better with the guys, but definitely not there yet.
To follow up on that really quickly, we spoke with Trey as well. He spoke about you guys' chemistry on the court, but also having a great chemistry off the court. Can you explain to us how great it's been to play with Trey Young and how you two's game can still grow together?
Yeah, I mean, he's so young, quick, talented. So last year we started talking a lot during all this virus thing. We were really always in touch with together, even whenever we're in LA. So it definitely helps when you have a good chemistry off the court. It also helps on the court. It also helps whenever communicate back and forth with each other. And like I said, we're not there yet, but we getting there. So it's really positive.
Thank you.
Clint, in your experience in the league, when a team's shooting goes cold late in the game, what are some things you can do to stay in the game and make sure you come away with the win?
Yeah, what's not easy, and I think what's missing from us tonight is you gotta keep attacking. It's not always easy that whenever you miss shots, sometimes you'll put shots and you have tough shots. You don't necessarily get all the calls that you think you should get, but it happens. It's part of the game. You gotta keep attacking to the rim, find easy shots, get to the free throw line, or you know, there's other ways. Whenever you get a stop, a run, get easy buckets, easy baskets, because definitely tonight was harder for us whenever the defense was set. So always trying to find ways. It's part of the game. What people tend to forget is that it's a game. So whenever you're trying to can get a quick one, a quick layup on a fast break, you got to get it because it's part of a game. It doesn't stop. So and that's what you should do whenever it's hard. It starts to get harder.
Thank you.
All right, Clint, I believe that was our final question for you. So thank you.
Thank you, guys.
All right, everybody. We'll see you in a couple of days. Thank you.
Thank you.